Ladies and gentlemen, first of all, I would like to welcome and every girl child fest both in private and public life under vigil of an unequal power relationship as constructed within our socio-economic structure. Women's economic dependency, legal subordination, social culture, obligations, and also suffered by superstition, malpractices, child marriages, polygamy, unmatched marriage, dowry system, witchcraft, etc. has made social status of women lower than men. Thus, women representing majority of our country's population can rarely play a vital role in country's politics too. In other words, feudalistic, patriarchal values, sociocultural norms, lack of education and employment opportunities, low level of awareness of legal rights, perpetrators of human trafficking have been able to trap our sisters easily. In our present Nepali women, we are 51.5% of our population, but our honorable constitution members are here. We are not advancing now after the 7th constant assembly election. As regards the women, we are retreating back. 33, before we had 33%, now we are not even to reach that percent even. So Nepal has passed Human Trafficking and Transportation Control Act in 2007. Office of the Prime Minister has a unit to coordinate ministerial actions for violence against women. Awareness programs are also focal point of them. Ministry of Women, Children and Social Welfare and National Women's Commission are also working on it. Even though 8 rehabilitation centers are established for victims of trafficking at different districts, despite referral to these centers, proper rehabilitation of the victims are very poor because of the few resources allocated to it. Here I would like to say that the women, children and social welfare